Hey guys, welcome back to You Make Take. In today's episode, I show you how to convert the Ender 3 Pro to direct drive using only stock parts and 3D printed parts. In order to do this, I use a SpeedDrive V1 from Thingiverse and I put the link in the description. I quite like the SpeedDrive design. It is simple and the motor location make it compatible with most cooling upgrades, Bullseye, Blokhead, HeroMe. Something to take into consideration, because the stock cooling on the Ender 3 Pro will quickly show its limits. If you don't want to follow the DIY route, you can get a direct drive upgrade from Creality for less than $40. This is a pretty good deal, taking into consideration that it comes complete with the extruder, the hot end, the nozzle, the cables and the fans. Unfortunately, the position of the motor in the Creality design prevents the installation of a cooling mode. Therefore, I decided to switch to the SpeedDrive design shown in this video. Before we start, we need to ask our Bowden extruder one last favor, to print two more parts, a mount plate for the motor and an end stop spacer. I printed this part with 6 volts and 50% gyroid fill. Make sure to print the end stop spacer. The end stop spacer is required because of the position of the motor. Without the end stop, the motor will slam into the frame. This is all you need to convert your Ender 3 Pro to direct drive. That's it for today. This is how I converted my MD3 Pro to direct drive. I hope you enjoyed this video today. Please let me know in the comments below. In the next episode, I will try to print some flexible filaments. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching and see you soon on You Make Tech.